For part two, let's explore confidence intervals for proportions. So what is P? P is the population proportion or population percentage or population probability. If you see any of these P words in the problem, you're talking about a P, a population proportion. And we use lowercase p to indicate that. So for example, if we're interested in the percentage of people who will vote for a particular candidate in an election, we're interested in P. Our point estimate will be the population proportion. Our point estimate for the population proportion is the sample proportion p hat. That should have been a 4 over there. So p hat is our sample proportion, just like x bar was our sample mean. Often, if you have a little symbol over a number, over a letter or a Greek letter, it's indicating it's a sample estimate. So p hat is our sample proportion. P hat is just x over n, where x is just the number of successes in our sample, where we define a success as being whatever we're interested in finding the proportion of. All right, this formula, it looks like a brand new formula, but realistically, this is what you would do even if you never had this class. So let's just talk about the sampling distribution in p-hat, and then we'll revisit explaining how to actually construct all these things. So when we constructed our confidence interval for the population mean, we went back to our understanding of the sampling distribution of x bar to do that. So just like there's a sampling distribution of x bar, there's also a sampling distribution of p hats that are done in a very similar manner. And just like the previous sampling distribution that we explored, the center of the sampling distribution of p hat will be the average for the p hats, which is actually just the population proportion. So in other words, the sampling distribution of p hat is going to be normal as long as you have a large enough sample, and it's going to be centered on p, the actual population proportion. And the standard error, which we can call sigma p hat, is the square root of pq over n. All right, again, don't worry too much about this. We're going to simplify this in a moment. Small little issue, though. Since we're going to use this to estimate the what the actual population proportion is, we can't know p and q beforehand. So we're going to use p hat and q hat in this formula instead. So long story short, our formula to construct a confidence interval for p is just going to be our p hat, our sample proportion, plus or minus this z alpha over 2. It's a z distribution because we know it's going to be normal, assuming the population is large enough. You don't need actually a sample size of 30. It's a little complicated establishing what is large enough, so don't worry about it for now. In chapter 6, we'll talk about what large sample means in context of proportions. But we're just going to take p hat plus or minus a z value times the square root of p hat q hat over n, where the square root of p hat q hat over n is really just our estimate for the standard error, just like before. All right, so let's just do, again, another fake example of who will win an election. So often before elections, random samples are done to estimate the proportion of voters that will vote for various candidates. There's all kinds of problems with these because often it's hard to do a random sample. And just because someone says they're going to vote doesn't mean they are going to vote. So there are issues with these, but let's assume that just everything is working out fine and we actually did a random sample and everybody we surveyed is going to vote, etc. So let's suppose for a fake election between Mr. Apple and Ms. Banana, there were 1,000 voters surveyed. Of those, 558 said they'd vote for Mr. Apple. So let's create a 99% confidence interval for the actual percentage of all voters that will vote for Mr. Apple. And just as a follow-up question, who do you think is going to win the election? All right, so to find our sample proportion, this is the percentage of people in our sample, or proportion of people in our sample, that will vote for the candidate that we're interested in. And in this case, we're talking about Mr. Apple. You're just going to take the number of people that said they'd vote for Mr. Apple over our sample size, so 558 over 1,000, which is 0.558 or 55.8%. In your project, I'm going to ask you to interpret this kind of number, and so your interpretation would be something like 55.8% of our sample said they would vote for Mr. Apple, something like that. Q hat, you might remember for this from the binomial distribution, Q is just 1 minus P. So Q hat is just 1 minus 0.558, which is 0.442, or 44.2%. So in other words, if there's only these two voters, then only these two candidates, I should say, 44.2% will vote for Ms. Banana. All right, so our z value is going to be 2.575, and I just took this off of the table I showed you in the previous lectures. Or remember, you can actually go, let me show you real quick. I'm going back quite a bit here to the t table. It's just somewhere. All right, remember the last line of the t table is the z table. Since we're generating a 99% confidence interval, our alpha over 2 value will be 0.005. So we're going to go down this column. We won't use these. So we just take the infinity line and we get 2.57. It says 2.576. I always use 2.575, but I mean, either way, you're going to get the same answer. It's almost identical. So that's our Z. All right, let's move on. All right, so our z alpha is 2.575. Then we take our p hat estimate, 0.558, add and subtract the z value times the square root of p hat q hat over n. So that's 2.575 square root 0.558 times 0.442 over 1,000. Be very careful when doing this calculation. Even I make mistakes with it a lot. Make sure you do all this first, 0.558 times 0.442 divided by 1,000. Then do the square root, then multiply it by 2.575. Like all of this has to be under the square root. Be very careful. And you might want to practice with this now just to make sure you can do this in your own calculator. But anyway, so when we do that, we should get approximately 0.040 for our margin of error. And when we add and subtract that from 0.558, we get 0.518 to 0.598. So in other words, we think between 51.8% to 59.8% of the voters will vote for Mr. Apple. Putting this in the context of the problem, we are 99% confident that the true percentage of all voters that will vote for Mr. Apple in the election falls between 51.8% to 59.8%. So, to answer the question, and I accidentally just showed it to you, but to answer the question, do we actually have a clear winner potentially for this election? And assuming that my sample is random and that I did everything correctly, well, it seems like Mr. Apple's going to get at least 51.8% of the votes, somewhere between 51.8% to 59.8%. So yes, since I think Mr. Apple's going to get over 50% of the votes, I'm 99% confident of that. I am 99% confident that Mr. Apple will win the election.